Venezuela is in the midst of a humanitarian crisis. Millions had fled among food and medicine shortages. Many blame the authoritarian regime of the sitting president, Nicolás Maduro. Juan Guaidó, the head of the National Assembly, is leading the opposition. He declared himself interim president in January, challenging Maduro, but gaining the support of many Venezuelans in 65 foreign countries. Maduro is refusing to step down. While some want full support from the U.S., others are wary of it getting too deeply involved in Venezuela's politics. More than 3.4 million Venezuelans have left the country since 2014. We talked to Venezuelans who have emigrated from the country about what they think the future holds and the families they left behind.
I think we were all forced to leave Venezuela and to find new opportunities in many places.
I feel like I don't have future in Venezuela.
I eat 3 meals a day, I have transportation, I have everything that I want to, something that I didn't have in Venezuela.
My family has been fighting and trying to find for food with the little money that they can earn from their jobs. Well, they haven't like cured many of their problems, health problems, because medicine cannot be found.
Mi familia subsiste con lo que yo envío, que es, a pesar de no ser en términos de dólares, no es una fortuna, representa muchos sueldos mínimos en Venezuela.
Having a dollar salary inside of Venezuela, it's absurd. The kind of living that you can have. And that's like the only way that you can actually have a proper lifestyle inside of Venezuela.
I stopped looking to the news and everything that was happening because it would like cost me so much pain.
A mí me duele profundamente lo que, cómo están masacrando a los jóvenes, cómo meten a cualquiera preso.
This is not a democratically elected government. These elections that passed came from a constituent assembly, came from a rigged Justice Department, came from a rigged electoral committee, all appointed by Maduro.
The Venezuelan citizens did elect the National Assembly, and Juan Guaidó is using his constitutional rights to become interim president.
I'm not saying that he's going to be a superhero that's going to save us. I want to believe that he's the man necessary.
I support them because they're trying to achieve a change that we need in our country since Chavez got in power.
I personally would hate if he put himself into the ballot for the elections when we get out of this.
We're not trying to get Guaidó to stay in the government. I just want him to get rid of this regime so we can do free elections and start rebuilding.
What is happening in Venezuela is affecting not just our country, it's affecting all the region. The U.S. need to take a leading role in this, not just because it's the strategic things to do, but also because it's a moral issue.
We tried protesting and we got attacked and many people got killed.
El pueblo venezolano ya necesita ayuda internacional, necesita intervención internacional. Nosotros no podemos solos.
The Trump administration and Trump himself has shown himself to be a racist. So he's not exactly the person at which was in charge right now, but what's happening in Venezuela is too important to become partisan about it.
We wouldn't want to become another colony of the United States.
And US invasion at this point, it'll be like the last resource. We're so desperate at this point that I think most of Venezuelans would take it.
We're not only up against Maduro and a regime, we're up against the drug lords, we're up against different guerrilla groups, we're up against terrorist cells.
I don't think any Venezuelans really want to see armed conflict. I don't think anybody wants any more people to die. But if it comes to that, I mean, I would hope there's a coalition of countries to help.
Yes, we don't want a war, but this is already a war. And this war that we're living right now is a war when we have no chance to survive.
I would love to go back to my country and just live the life I was supposed to be living if none of this would happen.
I don't want to go home. And that makes me feel bad for saying it, but I feel like I have a chance to have a future here.
We want to go back and, you know, and reconstruct the country, the economy.
En el momento que esto caiga, agarro a mi hijo y nos vamos a nuestro país. Venezuela va a salir adelante.
This is not about left-wing politics versus right-wing politics. This is not about capitalism versus socialism or Trump versus Maduro. It's about basic human rights. We have been torn apart from our families. So I really wish that to end.